sit here for another round. Gonna be on the play this game. Hand was pretty solid. Again, need a land, but I haven't seen many opulent palaces these days. Maybe he's some like Esper splash green deck. That was a good draw. Now our hand's just fantastic if I draw a land. And if I don't, it's still okay. Assuming he doesn't kill us. If he kills us, then I still need to draw land. Maybe he's some like Sadisi deck or something. I haven't seen those in, you know, since rotation basically. That was not the best driver, but it was fine. Next turn I can play Archive into Pilgrimage, so. Retreat to Hagra, huh? Alright. That's a lot of Ulamogs. Land there would have been great, because I could have cast this Renewal. So 6, 7, 8, 9. So I can cast Ulamog next turn if I draw land. And he probably can't possibly win if I do that. To be fair, I'm probably gonna win anyway, even though I didn't draw land there. Yeah, I thought maybe if he has like Disdainful Stroke for this or something and I never draw land, maybe I'd lose, but I'm gonna morph this. So there's a fairly high percentage chance that we're winning this game. If I lose this game, I should not play this deck at the Grand Prix, that's for sure. Okay, don't really care about that. Ooh, I can even go get a 4th Ugin. I'm just gonna exile his 2 black sources. And not go get another Ugin. I draw like Nissa or something, and then I can cast Nissa and Ulamog, or yeah, Ulamog, not Ugin, but yeah. I'm just gonna attack and then exile 2 more lands. Maybe I won't be attacking. Anticipate, okay. I guess this time I'll crack my Sanctum in case he plays like Swamp, Transgress the Mind or something. Don't really know that I want a sideboard. I didn't really see enough of his deck. He's like some slow control deck, but he has green, so he could have. I didn't see white though, so I guess he probably doesn't have Abzan Charm. Maybe Geyser Range is still great. I think I'm gonna play Geyser Range instead of Hangar Back, or maybe instead of Nissa's Renewal, because he did not seem aggressive at all. I still like Nissa's Renewal. It does give me a lot of lands. I'll cut one of these Hangar Backs. I just hate Hangar Back Walker. I feel like I have to play it in the deck because you need, you know, extra things to crack your Sanctums in some games, but I'm gonna mulligan this. Like, I can, sure, I can cast my spells, you know, I can morph this Rattleclaw, but it's, even still, it's not great. I don't have any threats. That sounds much better. I'll top that. Not exactly a threat, but I feel like this is a matchup where I'm probably going to need to cast multiple Ugins, or Ulamog, sorry. So the Sylvan Scrying is important to be able to get Sanctum. Don't know if I quite wanted a second one, but that's okay. I Could cast Sylvan Scrying here because if he has a removal spell, I can Nissa's Pilgrimage for sure next turn. I'm going to do that. That was a good draw. So now I could Pilgrimage or Morph Rattleclaw. I think I just want to Pilgrimage here. Again, I want to be sure that I can cast Explosive Vegetation next turn. I'm not really sure what he's trying to do. Let's see. Yeah, I'm just going to Explosive Vegetations here. Oh, I should have gotten double planes there. Just in case I draw like another Pilgrimage or something after I draw another forest. I don't know. There's no way I'm going to need a fifth forest. Duress, alright. So he should take my Sylvan Scrying, but I think that's probably what he'll take. Sylvan Scrying is basically another Ulamog with this hand. Nope. So 5, 6, 7. Okay, so I'm just gonna morph this guy. I'm gonna play Vegetation first in case he has Scatter the Winds. Or not Scatter the Winds. That Clash of Wills. So Scatter the Winds obviously will counter it no matter what. I wonder if he's playing like Kiora or something. That's why he's playing blue and green. So he just seems like a bad Esper deck right now, from what I've seen so far. I guess I haven't seen. I guess I saw Retreat to Hagra last game and that was it, so I really haven't seen anything. So who knows what he's playing. He seems like a control deck though. See what he's got. I'm next list, maybe? Crux of Fate, okay. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That's a perfect number. I'm just gonna cast this Ulamog. Yeah, like I only have 3 forests left in my deck now, so. Obviously, I've already gotten both the planes, but. Why a reason to get the planes first. I'm pretty sure I want to hit his 2 blue sources here. Suck this, get another Ulamog. I can't actually cast it next turn unless I draw a land. Retreat to Hagra. I don't understand this card in his deck, from what I've seen. Because if he's a control deck, it seems like the green retreat should be way better. Because it's gained 2 life per land. There obviously must be something else to his deck that I haven't seen. But I don't know what he wants to get. It's not like, there's not like a pinger in this format that giving Death Touch to is great. Should I cast some random spells? Then I'll morph this, play Sylvan Scrying. I guess maybe I shouldn't have played this Rattleclaw. I don't know if there's anything that makes me discard a card, but obviously there's Colgan's Command. I mean, I'm just playing around that, but there's probably nothing. There's like the discard two awaken spell. I mean, it's very unlikely, but and that also doesn't play around anyway, it's got discard two, so. Alright, well, so that was. The deck performed okay. I'm still undecided if I'm going to play the white version or the green version for the GP this weekend, but I'll certainly be casting Ulamog, so just got to hope to dodge mono red. And I think the Aristocrat decks are kind of bad matchups too, but so we'll see. Thanks for watching.